Probably you have a red worker with a radio button. A field like this one. With we can select options, and when one option is selected, the another is automatically unselected. So here we have this red option selected. If we click on green, green begin to be selected and red is automatically unselected. And the same will happen when we click in another radio button. Okay, so it's a single choice selector for multiple options. Let's in this video understand how this kind of field is defined and how we can iterate with that when we are programming with a front-end programming language such as JavaScript. So open here the code. Let's understand how this field is built. With this tag, that's the input tag with the type of radio, we build one radio input, one single radio input. So this tag will draw in the interface this single button here. However, for we have this behavior for the three options being linked, for the system understanding that when you click in another one, it automatically unselected the previous options, we have to set the same name for all of them. When we set the same name, the system understands that they make part of the same group. And when one input is clicked, the other are unselected. Then they have the same name, but they could have different values. You have to understand that the value we are going to see in the interface is not exactly the same value the system understands. So this text here, out the tag, is just for user read. The value that the system understands is the one that are inside the tag. So this value is here. So because they have the same name, user can switch between them and we have this automatically unselected effect. Okay, so here you already have understood how we have draw the button, radio button in the interface. Now you have to understand how to work with that. When we click in this button here that is available here, how the system will identifies what of the three radio buttons was selected. So let's understand the code that is behind this handle radio button. Basically, we have two. We have here a function. We have to access the field. The first hint, you have to access the field based in their name, not by their ID. In case we have set the one ID here instead of the name, the ID will take the individual input, but we don't want the individual input. We want to take the whole field, the group. So we have to inform the name. Then the system will understand it's a group of radio buttons. It's a group of nodes, of elements. And then we can identify how many buttons there is. And then we can verify for each of them if they are checked or not checked. Being checked, this H boot of the radio button field is this information. Now blue is checked. Now green is checked. So the H boot has the value of true. Otherwise, blue and red has the value of false. So checked attribute identifies it selected or not. Then in case it's selected, they are going to present the value in the user console. So here, all the output of the function is printed in the console. Please observe, I'm printing here the whole object that returns when we access the field based in its name, and also the type of its field, for we understand what the system understand for the return of this variable. So let's hit here. Here our console is being displayed. I select blue and click it in the random radio button. And here we have, it's one object from the type of object. And here is the output object has returned. So it's from the class radio node list. So it's a list with three inputs with the length of three. has a value of true, of blue. But we, to identify the exactly selected option, we can make that loop through each of these options to verify if it's selected or not checked. So you have here checked attribute, you see? True, because it's selected. Another options will be unchecked, so the checked will be false. Right here, we see here, checked is false. You can observe that we have directly the value here, but you cannot trust because sometimes some browsers does not have this property available. So it's safer if you loop through them and identifies. Okay, here were some hints about how you can handle this radio button component in the web programming. This code is available to be downloaded from the video description, and thank you for watching.